Now I can get to labeling some stuff and get that amp hooked up. Hey guys, and welcome back to another random review. I recently purchased an amp for my home theater and realized when I was trying to go hook it up that I would either have to unhook one cable at a time and rehook it back up, or I could try to label them so that it would be easier to do. I decided that labeling was the way to go. So of course I went on Amazon to see what they had available, and I came across the Phomemo D30, a small thermal label printer. While looking at it, I noticed that the labels that it came with were a little bit too small to wrap around cables, but I quickly saw that they actually had a variety of cables. One of them was specifically four cables, and from the picture it actually looked like they were yellow, so I clicked on it to see if they had other colors, and luckily they had a blue, or how I like to call it, Emotiva blue. The other thing that I liked about the printer is that it used an app to actually create the labels. So I ordered the white version. It also actually comes in green, gray, which actually looks like a shark, pink, and turquoise. The printer at the time was $29.59, and the three rolls of the Emotiva blue cables were $12.76. I'm not going to do an unboxing, but the packaging was actually pretty simple. Of course, there's the printer itself, and then a charging cable, although it's actually a really short charging cable. Of course, some guides and stuff, a quick start guide and the instructions. And inside the printer is the actual roll that they send you of labels. First thing I did was plug it in to charge, and as I mentioned, the cable itself is actually kind of short. I measured it with a ruler and it's about 12 inches, so you can still make it work. Once it was completely charged, I started setting it up. Per the quick start guide, the first thing you have to do is download the app. There is a QR code in the guide, but when I tried to use that, it actually didn't work for me. So I just went to the app store and did a search for Printmaster and was able to get it that way. When you first start up the app, the first thing it asks you to do is to sign in. I didn't really see the point to that, but luckily there is a skip sign in button, so did that instead. Next, you want to make sure Bluetooth is on and the printer is on to connect the printer to the app. This took me to the label creation portion, which you do have a light mode and a creation mode. Light mode is kind of simple and creation mode is more like advanced. I tried the creation mode first, and it does allow you to place lots of different things like text, icons, borders, pictures, the time, barcodes, QR codes, lines, shapes, and some functionality that I was impressed that it even had, like using an Excel file for batch printing of labels, barcode scanning, forms, OCR from images, and voice recognition. However, for what I needed it for, light mode was a little easier. It's easy to make simple labels that have the text right in the middle, but still allows you to change the size and font, although some of the fonts do need to download first, but it's quick. It does allow you to add things like date, time, and symbols too. Overall, I'm really impressed of how much the app allows you to do for labels. The one downside that I came across, especially in creation mode, is that it doesn't allow you to like pinch to zoom so you can zoom in on the label and make like little fine adjustments. So sometimes when you're trying to move stuff around, it's a little bit hard to pick the right thing or adjust the arrows in the right way. But as far as what I needed, that's probably not going to be an issue. I was playing around with the software last night while I was in bed, and I was surprised that I was actually able to save the labels so that I could print them later. One thing to note is that in the light mode, it just saves, but in creation mode, you can save as and give it a specific name. Putting labels in is also pretty straightforward. You do have to put them in a certain way so that the labels are facing the print head. It uses thermal printing, so there is no ink, but I wondered how well it would look. To my surprise, it looked really good. The text looks really sharp, and since I used a thicker font, it's easy to read. Well, that's really about it. Like I said, I think it works really great. The app is really easy to use, especially if you use the light mode, but it allows you to do a lot more stuff if you go into creation mode. And I'm happy with the way the labels print out. If you found this review helpful, I would definitely appreciate a like on this video, and make sure to subscribe and hit that notification bell so you'll be notified when the next video drops, so you can see what the labels look like on the actual cables themselves. But until then, I hope you have a good one.